Welcome back to Nautical Depths. From ancient battlefields to uncharted territories beneath the ocean waves, the face of warfare is changing rapidly. If you're new here, remember to subscribe and turn on notifications so you never miss a thought-provoking discussion. Today, we're taking a deep dive into the realm of AI, specifically China's underwater AI robots, and their potential threat to US supremacy. We're going to peel back the layers on this complex and highly sensitive issue. Warfare. A term synonymous with human history has always been marked by the ever-evolving strategies and technologies that define it. From the humble beginnings of stone tools to the sophistication of nuclear weapons, warfare has transformed in ways that our ancestors could hardly imagine. And today, we stand on the precipice of yet another seismic shift in the way wars are fought. Throughout history, war has been a cruel constant. Hand-to-hand combat in ancient times gave way to the devastating power of artillery in the modern era. Swords and shields became obsolete as technology evolved, paving the way for firearms and ultimately nuclear weapons. War, in its very essence, is about gaining the upper hand over your adversary, and technology has always been a crucial part of that power struggle. But now, we stand at a juncture in human history where our innovations are no longer merely about maximizing destructive power, but about minimizing human involvement in the actual combat. We've seen how technology has progressively distanced the soldier from the battlefield. From the longbows of medieval times to today's drones operated from thousands of miles away. But we're on the cusp of a new age in warfare, an age defined by artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, or AI as it's commonly known, has become an integral part of our lives. From powering our smartphones to driving our cars, AI is everywhere. But now, it's making its way onto the battlefield. Military powers worldwide are investing heavily in AI technology, seeking to develop intelligent machines that can outthink, outmaneuver, and outfight their human counterparts. The idea of using AI in warfare isn't new, but the scale and sophistication of today's technology are. Countries are actively working on AI-driven drones, missile defense systems, and yes, even autonomous combat robots. But one nation seems to be leading this race, transforming not just how wars will be fought, but also where they will be fought, China. So let's dive deeper into this and examine China's venture into underwater AI warfare. China is no stranger to the world of artificial intelligence. Known for its aggressive pursuit of technological advancement, the country has now turned its focus towards integrating AI with warfare. Building upon its existing dominance in AI sectors, China has developed new machinery that moves beyond the realms of traditional warfare. Machinery capable of causing catastrophic damage without endangering a single human life on its side. This lethal combination of technology and tactics is shifting the balance of power, posing a significant challenge to other nations, including the US. Let's delve into the revolutionary world of China's underwater AI robots. These marvels of technology, known as unmanned underwater vehicles, or UUVs, are pushing the boundaries of AI and warfare. Like stealthy sharks patrolling the ocean depths, these robots operate beneath the waves, invisible to conventional radar systems. But these are no simple machines. Each UUV is equipped with state-of-the-art machine learning systems. These systems gather and analyze data from the robot's surroundings, making decisions in real time with unprecedented accuracy. An enemy submarine, for instance, can be identified autonomously. Upon identification, the UUV can launch torpedoes without any human intervention. It's akin to having an advanced and precise soldier who never tires, never questions, and operates ceaselessly under the vast ocean surface. This is the formidable power and potential of China's underwater AI robots. But why, you may wonder, would China unveil this secret weapon to the world? Well, in the game of global power politics, such a revelation is far from accidental. It's a calculated move, a declaration of advanced capabilities designed to send a strong message to the world. China's unveiling of their underwater AI robots is a show of force, a demonstration of their technological prowess and military power. For Taiwan and Japan, this revelation is a stark reminder of China's growing might. For the US, it's a direct challenge to its long-held naval dominance. By revealing this technology, China is compelling other nations to confront a new reality and triggering a potential AI arms race. In this high-stakes game of power and dominance, the revealing of China's secret weapon is an assertive move that can't be ignored. The advent of China's underwater AI robots is a game changer, and its ripples are already being felt across the global political landscape. As nations scramble to respond to this new threat, we could witness shifts in alliances, increased military spending, and the acceleration of AI warfare development around the world. The rules of the game have changed. The question now is, how will the world adapt to this new reality? Underwater is not the only domain where autonomous bots are taking the stage. Across the globe, countries and corporations are developing various types of AI bots designed for different types of warfare, from autonomous drones scanning the skies to ground vehicles patrolling disputed borders. AI warfare isn't just a concept anymore, it's a reality. In fact, there are even gliders, self-driving bots that study water conditions and transmit data back to base. On the surface, these gliders look harmless, but equipped with the right weapons or surveillance equipment, they could become another tool in the ever-evolving arms race. But as we move further into the age of AI warfare, we must also consider the potential downsides. What happens if these machines malfunction, or if their AI misinterprets a situation leading to unwanted conflict? Or worse yet, what if these machines end up in the wrong hands, turning from protectors to threats? These are not just theoretical concerns. With every new technology comes a new potential for misuse or disaster. In the case of AI warfare, the stakes are as high as they can get. China isn't the only country pushing the boundaries of AI warfare. Israel, for instance, has successfully used AI bots to intercept rockets, saving countless lives. And then there's the United States, which has its own underwater tech known as Orca. Developed with the help of Boeing, Orca is designed to scout waters and conduct unmanned missions. In fact, many nations are waking up to the possibilities and potential advantages of AI in warfare, investing heavily in research and development. It's clear that we are entering a new era of warfare, one that will be fought not just by soldiers on the ground, but by machines in the sky, on the ground, and underwater. There's a growing consensus that global regulations are needed to manage this technology. However, creating these regulations and ensuring they are respected across international borders will be a daunting task. It would require a common understanding and cooperation at an international level, akin to nuclear non-proliferation treaties. But given the potential for misuse and the high stakes involved, it is a challenge that we must face head-on. In this brave new world of AI warfare, it's clear that we stand on the precipice of a new era. From underwater bots to AI drones, we're witnessing a seismic shift in the way conflicts are conducted and resolved. But with new technology comes new responsibility, and it is incumbent upon us all to ensure that these advancements are used responsibly and ethically. Let's keep this important conversation going. We want to hear your thoughts on this. How do you feel about the rise of AI warfare? What do you think the ethical guidelines should be? Should there be global regulations? And if so, who should enforce them? Share your thoughts in the comments below. And if you found this video informative, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Until our next video, stay informed, stay engaged, and keep questioning.